Hi guys, today on the bench some Soviet aircraft oddity. It is an antenna. I believe it is part from the Sirena 3 radar alerter system, which was mainly used on two MiG-21 fighter. It was a 4 radar beam detector mainly, and it did alert the pilot when radar did highlight the aircraft with the goal of firing a missile at the aircraft. So we have this thing, as you can see. Manufacturer plate, L006LM. Serial number 1339. So as you can see, it is some kind of metal thing. With here 4 coax connectors, some attachment points here, and here the sensitive window, I should say, while the transparent, this part is transparent to the high frequency waves, and hides the kind of antennas inside. It is really a weird thing, so if I unclip this first, there will be some fast forward parts, I believe, in this video, because taking it apart is quite a pain. Here we are. So this front part seems to be some kind of fiberglass material. By the way, I did have, I don't remember, 4 or 6 of these devices. I did sell some of them, and it keep only the best looking ones. I have 2 remaining, I believe. So here you are, you can see this part is some kind of, yes, glass fiber material, something like this. Composite material, very light. You can see the kind of mesh it is made of. And here you have what seems to be the wave guide block with many holes inside, some kind of wall material. So we will, I will unscrew all the body and we will have a look inside. So, by the way, I just remember I have these things with a matching model number L006M, and I believe these things connect to that thing like so. So it is some kind of preamplifier module or something like this. Yes, front end amplifier, I could guess, something like so. And yes, so you can see there is a center coax conductor and some kind of outside shielding. So you should need 2 of them by for each antenna. But I think they do go together. Quite nice. So this model of coax is typically Soviet. Okay, nice. We will have a look in the box another time. So, if I finish with unscrewing this, So I did just find another one of them. I have at least three of them remaining. Okay, so you can see the body here to screw the shielding on, made of aluminium. And here we have a little better view at the connectors. You can see there are four screws all around, two screws in the middle. So obviously, whatever we have in it, it is really well made and complicated. So I will continue taking things apart. Okay, hopefully I did remove everything necessary to open it. So let's try to pry it open. Maybe this metal rod here is preventing things to pry apart. Not sure. Maybe yes. Yes. Definitely it is the same part all across, so
we need a
little bit of help from the hammer. It looks like very delicately, of course. It should be coming off like this. This side is mostly good to go. Okay. This metal rod is really annoying. Okay, so top cover is off. You can see diecast aluminium body, some material here, not sure what it is. It is hard, looks like some kind of composite material, so not sure. Rubber on the side here, and here are the goodies, guys. We have some kind of cheese here, really. So it is not identified material. It looks like the holes here has some metal deposit in them. So maybe they add like reflectors or something like this. Not sure, but maybe I can test it with a multimeter and see if it is conductive or not. If I take a bigger one, no, weird. Okay, so this is the, I will call this the cheese part. It looks like a cheese, some kind of hard, don't know if it is plastic, some kind of stuff. I should guess there is a what seems to be a serial number on it. part number. No, part. It says part in the Cyrillic. Okay, and here we have the antennas. Looks like this thing contains four antennas with waveguides here. And we must have some sensitive part. So by the way, if I remove these screws here, it may allow to remove this part, but there is no really point to it. So there, the thing here did just fall off. Look at this, there is a serial number, and it seems we have the weight written here. Quite interesting. You see, it's for balancing purpose. Not sure. We will check if it is the weight. It says 7.5 grams. And surely not, it is not the weight. Okay, so it is quite a fail. What else? So there is also a part number written here, looks like. So I will try to remove one of these antennas here, but it may be difficult because the screws are locked with some kind of very hard epoxy or something like this. So I will see if it is possible or not to unscrew this part, but it looks like the screws are very, very well secured. Yes, so it will not come off that easily. So I guess I will have to stop here, this tear down. Maybe we can unscrew the other side here also. So the number of screws in this thing is quite impressive. As you can guess, I will need some time to put it back together. It is coming off, at least this part. Yes. So here is the antenna array, I should call it, I guess. Again, where the material, I don't know what it is. This is some kind of Teflon, maybe. Rubber here for dampening. And here we have some probably waveguides with antenna elements here at the root of the thing. No serial number, nothing written on it here. You can see the case is pretty thick and obviously die-cast metal. You can see some shielding stuff here, some metal wire to shielding the thing. Okay, so this is quite weird, the kind of weird stuff you can find in old MIGs. Really interesting, not the stuff you see usually. And when you can find such stuff on mainly onto eBay Germany, you will find MIG parts for really, really cheap. In particular, this kind of ugly parts, I should get to say. Okay, next video, we will have a look in the pre-amplifier box that connect to it. Now I will try to put all this back together. Thanks for watching, and don't forget your cake. Bye bye.